Drazek from UDF2 Gaming here, and we're back. Last episode was a nasty one, wasn't it? We ended up with practically everybody gravely wounded for multiple days. Drazek is 17, Athena's 23 days. Khan, on his first mission, got taken out for 17 days. Luckily, Baron's only 5, so I might be able to use him in the next mission we come across. Now I'm going to have to start using some of these rookies and let everyone rest. This is crazy! This is crazy! What else we got going on though? So, what to do? We have a proving ground and there's currently no items in the build queue. So, let's click on that and see what that does. April Watson, project time 50%, minus 50%. Shoot, yes, let's make a project! Skull mining! What is this? As if the skulljack itself wasn't invasive enough, Togan has conceived a more fun blah 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 skull mining technique. Oh yeah, okay, so we researched that the other day, in the last episode I think. We can make another skulljack if I want, but I've already got one so I'm not going to bother. Experimental ammo and experimental grenades. Costellurium cores, and what is it? Is it... does it give me a grenade? Seeing the aliens using a variety of exotic ammunition in their weapons, using Illyrium cores we've recovered from battlefield, we could develop new ammo types of our own that will likely be more potent than any of our current munitions! Bigger grenades! Illyrium cores can be highly unstable given the right circumstances. Assuming we don't push it too far, we could fabricate new types of grenades that would easily surpass the effectiveness of what we got now. Okay. So, better ammo and better grenades. Better guns, better... you know what, I'm going to make better grenades, because grenades have been doing me quite well so far. Alternatively, I could do the skull mining, but no!
Interesting choice. I'll send word as soon as we're finished, Commander.
Grenades it is. Grenades!
What can I do for you, Commander?
Hi! You can do everything for me!
There's room for us to expand our facilities on board the Avenger, Commander, but we'll need more engineers to clear out space for construction first.
Alright, I gotta clear some debris. Let's clear some debris. Here we go. Oh yeah, because I rescued a engineer, so that allows me to do that. I've got one engineer busy at the proving ground, so I guess if I wanted to, I could send her over there.
Commander, I'm going to need excavate. More help on the engineering team before I can start clearing out some of these other rooms.
There we go.
An engineer.
Oh, problem. Problem. Did I just mess up the proving grounds? Oh, I think I did. Because I need to make the experimental grenades, but you need an engineer in the proving grounds in order to make it, otherwise, yeah, you get no problem. Okay, fine. Draz, stop spazzing!
As far as I can tell, advanced technology, along with most of what we've seen going on in the city centers, is based on variations, and in some cases, improvements of the existing alien tech used during the invasion.
Okay,
luckily, the more common this stuff becomes, the easier it'll be for us to find components that can work in conjunction with the Avengers' hybrid systems.
Hello, Commander.
Fun!
Work is well underway, but it will
well,
be
we've got 2 days left for resistance radio. That's what we were doing. We were building resistance radio in the previous episode because we need to go and grab... oh, crap.
The creature your troops defeated here was clearly of some importance to the aliens, Commander. Let us hope that the recovered remains prove equally important to our own efforts.
Okay. Intact structures, rookies. What's this? Resistance has detected activity of interest here. If the Avenger scans the area, XCOM can investigate these reports. Alright, I can do that. I need to make contact still, but I can't make contact until I get my radio. That's in 2 days. I need the supply drops, which is 2 days.
Avenger
conveniently, let's do that.
Force.
I should probably think about making the fifth UDF2 member, but I don't actually have a slot for him. However, it looks like I have 3 men down.
Commander,
so
we have a priority message coming through. It looks like an encoded signal.
I might make one anyway.
Patching it through to your quarters now.
Alright. Oh, is it the dude? Yes, it's the dude.
Hello, Commander.
Hello, dude.
It would seem your recent activities have gotten Advent's attention.
Our unwelcome guests are on the move. Advent has been diverting considerable resources and personnel to covert facilities across the globe. The exact details of these operations are highly classified. However, they do have one thing in common. A single word that appears in all their files. Avatar.
They're going to make big blue men.
The site we had previously uncovered to be but a part of this Avatar project. Based on what we have uncovered so far, its true scope is far greater. This project is being directed from the very top of Advent, from a source I am still unable to determine. All attempts to uncover its identity have met with failure. It is time to take a more direct approach. Though we may not know the exact nature of this Avatar project, we can still disrupt it. We must root out these hidden facilities with the help of local resistance cells, disrupt our enemy's operations, and in the process, uncover the truth. Locate the source of this Avatar project, and then destroy it. Were the enemy to succeed in their efforts, I am certain it would mean the end for us all. I am confident you will take whatever measures necessary to eliminate this threat, Commander.
I shall!
We're tracking the alien's progress on this Avatar project here.
We need to complete our primary objectives to locate the source of the Avatar project. Sure!
The end for all of us.
Whoa, what's going on? Okay. Right, I guess this is the main plot of the whole game. And the Avatar project, the aliens have started the Avatar project. If this bar hits max, I fail, I guess. Just like in XCOM 1, if the red hits max, you fail. There must be ways to reduce these squares somehow. I'm not entirely sure how. There's some dark events up here. Does that do it? I don't know. Well, we'll find out as we play. There must be ways to get rid of the bars and stop the Avatar project so that we don't end up losing. But until then, let's get a supply drop.
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing as I do, Commander.
Yes, I will. The Avenger serves our purposes adequately in terms of coordinating our communications network. But if we hope to increase our range and reach every possible outlet, we will have to do more. A series of carefully positioned relay towers would suffice, assuming we can miniaturize the technology we've adapted from the alien's own communications equipment. It may be difficult to balance the requisite power levels versus the increased chances of detection, but this is our best chance to expand on our capabilities. With the increased coverage, we can expect the efficiency of local resistance operations to improve, strengthening the groups working within range of the towers. Okay. Ooh. Advent Stun Lancer Autopsy available. Righty! Oh, instant! Done, straight away! Do it!
The Advent Stun Lancer was apparently outfitted with the intention of serving as a civilian peacekeeping unit within the city centers. Although they are equipped with weapons capable of administering non-lethal blows, recent reports indicate an increasingly aggressive stance taken by these units.
Yeah, aggressive stance of
bleh.
Sticking sticks up my bum, that's what they do.
Their means of dealing with any unruly civilians within the city centers. It seems they have come to rely on more brutal means of pacification in the time since.
Yeah, stick up the bum. On both the physical and genetic level, the Advent Stun Lancers are nearly identical to the troopers our forces regularly see in combat. However, a minor yet crucial adjustment to the muscular fiber density of the Lancer improves both agility and overall survivability. Equipped with non-lethal weapons capable of easily disabling human targets, these Lancers were first deployed during the earliest days following Advent's establishment of the city centers, when civil unrest was a more common problem than outright resistance. In studying their usage and deployment, this raised an interesting question. If the Lancers were among the first Advent forces deployed, and their survivability is somewhat higher than that of the standard trooper, did the aliens consciously reduce the trooper's strength based on their assessment of human combat readiness? This would imply a system of rapid genetic modification beyond what I had previously imagined the aliens were capable of. It would also demonstrate a degree of genetic frugality. that I would have previously assumed was irrelevant to the aliens, based on the variety of unusual experiments they've conducted. Hey, I get an arc blade! Drazek's gonna like that. I guess I'll continue the research. Right, alien encryption I have to do as part of the mission. And also, it's not 8 days, but we've got a trooper for 3, a faceless for 3. Oh, those faceless, what the hell was that? Psionics, which I can't do, and plated armor. Well, let's do these guys.
My past surgical experience is limited. I am sure the crew appreciates that I hone my skills on fallen Advent forces before triaging our own wounded. To the uninitiated, the common Advent trooper is seemingly human. The aliens have disguised this most glaring divergence from the human form with a carefully designed helmet.
Yeah, they got weird messed up faces. Alright, research ready. Let's just go back to the our soldiers. Who have we got available? So Baron's still 4 days away. Though Estella Serrano, a sharpshooter, has made it back. We've only got 4 classes to play with. 2 more UDF2 members to create. So I only really want 1 sharpshooter. The ranger possibly could have 2 rangers going. But I definitely want 2 specialists, and maybe 2 grenadiers would be nice as well, actually. So I might do another grenadier. I've got a rookie. I've got a specialist as well in 3 days. Well, let's keep going until we come up against a actual mission, and then we'll see what we'll do.
Commander, based on my research in collaboration with Shen, I believe we can reduce the intel costs of contacting additional regions by building radio relay towers along our network. The further a region is from a relay, the more it will cost us in intel. So I would suggest building relays along the remote edges of our existing network. I believe the Resistance will be grateful for the construction of these relays. They may reward us in kind.
Okay. So how do you make a relay then? If I make relays along the edges, it makes it cost less intel to contact further away region. Make contact with New Arctic. That's New Arctic. Complete the alien encryption. Well, I have to make contact with New Arctic because that's what I've got to do. But now I've got the supply drop.
Commander, to aid in your efforts, we have gathered additional resources and staff at Resistance Headquarters for your use.
Okay. New scientist engineers and veteran soldiers available for recruitment, so I can go and recruit, which is cool, but I want to make contact first.
Commander, we've utilized all of our available communications capacity. We can't establish any new contacts until we upgrade our systems.
Contacts 3 of 3. No, that can't be right. No, I've made the thing. Resistance HQ gain intel. Making contact 4 days remaining. 4 days remaining. 5 days remaining.
Attempting to establish local.
I'm just
going to
click it and
contact.
See what happens. Because
I do not think I could have predicted this outcome, though it is intriguing. Despite a thorough analysis, I have yet to discover what, if any, advantage the Advent hybrid soldiers' enormous eyes
Advent
provide.
Trooper autopsy.
Testing their visual acuity will no doubt prove difficult.
The most public face of Advent security. The standard Advent trooper serves in a first response role in areas of high public exposure. Although rumors as to their origins have persisted for years, it's only recently that we've confirmed that they are in fact the product of a human-alien hybrid development. My initial autopsy indicates that the troopers were at once time entirely human, implying some means of gradual genetic enhancement without the rejection concerns that would normally plague these experiments. The body itself maintains the general outward appearance of a typical human, but the most crucial changes occurring in the cranial structure. It is my belief that the Advent Troopers receive their orders, that is to say, are controlled, directly through a psionic link engineered as part of the genetic modification process. As we first discovered in the field, the eyes are notably larger, perhaps as an unintended side effect, as they seem to provide only limited improvements to the troopers' visual acuity. The aliens managed to disguise this glaring physical trait from the general public through the use of cleverly designed armor. Yes, helmets that cover your eyeballs. Ooh! The battle scanner provides extra vision on the battlefield, so I just put like a grenade, throw it to a hidden area of the map that they want to reveal. That could be quite useful. Go on then, let's do the faceless.
I am at a loss for words to describe the difficulties we have had in attempting to handle this creature, affectionately known as the Faceless, to our troops. The nebulous form of its physical structure, including a pliable, semi-solid outer layer, seems to be slowly degrading now that the creature has expired. There is also a pungent odor that only seems to grow stronger as time passes.
Disgusting, weird, globby things with claws. Right, I'm going to continue to make contact because... Experimental grenade complete. Hey! One acid grenade has been added to the inventory. The addition of a corrosive chemical additive to our standard frag grenades results in a small explosive that is especially effective at removing enemy armor. Targets will continue to suffer persistent damage as the acid clings to them and continues to eat away at any surface it touches. That sounds brilliant. Aim to be cleared so I can make a new room. Ooh, what can I make? Scientists can be staffed in laboratories to provide additional assistance, further decreasing the time of all research. Okay, that's cool. Engineers can be staffed in workshops, reducing using gremlin drones, which can be sent to staff any adjacent room. Okay, fine. Power relay gives me power. Eventually requires power to maintain operation. Building relays increase the total power output. Advanced warfare center. Once the AWC is built, soldiers may gain a bonus ability outside of their current class whenever they are promoted. Yes! In addition, an engineer can be staffed in the AWC to decrease the time our soldiers need to recover from injuries. I definitely need that. Guerrilla Tactics School. The Guerrilla Tactics School will unlock additional skills and benefits for our soldiers, including an increase in the number of soldiers we can take on a single mission. Uh-huh. So one of the Day 1 DLCs adds a new bunch of skills that you can give to a leader class. Like leader skills. And it basically gives him some extra stuff that he can do during the missions. Resistance comms. The resistance comms facility increases the number of regions that we can make contact with. Further contacts can be gained by staffing an engineer here once construction is complete. Okay. So if I build that, then I can make contact with more regions. I need the advanced warfare center there because I need my people to not be dead for so long.
Which means we can't expand our facilities further.
What? There's currently an on-staff engineer who can assist in building advanced work. Would you like? Yeah, of course I do. Something about power. Am I running out of power? My power's at capacity. Power 12 of 12. Well, bugger it! Does that mean I need... Oh. I might have to make new power, more power, before I can use that new facility. We shall see. Also, I am establishing communications. Great!
Why, hello there. We are XCOM. You join us now.
New objective added.
Investigate the Advent Black Site. Complete the Advent Black Site mission.
Commander,
okay.
We've established contact with the local resistance and we're ready to move on the alien Black Site on your order. Advent's been keeping this facility a closely guarded secret. We should make sure our troops are ready for a tough fight before we send them out there. I've updated our latest operational objectives, Commander.
Well, okay, so we've got more areas to contact. Western US. East Asia. Something about a mission? Oh, here, the Black Site mission. This remote alien facility is heavily guarded by the Advent. We need to investigate the site on behalf of the Resistance and report back immediately. Yeah, but the guy warned me to make sure I'm really ready for it before I go in and get myself killed. So I'm going to make sure I'm taking a full team to that mission. So until then, I need to do some other stuff, like more research. Intact structures, get those.
Avenger plotting new course.
Get those structures. I've got a supply drop. What's
these
a supply drop?
Will likely prove crucial to our ongoing efforts, Commander.
Damn faceless.
I've often wondered how the aliens.
Oh, that's a long one.
Such a being. Is there another world out there filled with these shape-shifting creatures, or are they merely another construct of alien genetic tampering?
Okay, early reports from the Resistance referencing an alien creature said to be capable of shapeshifting were initially dismissed by local cell leaders who attributed the sightings to combat stress and malnutrition. It wasn't until our own forces engaged with the creature that we successfully confirmed its existence. Oh, you weren't lying? Surprisingly enough, the description of the creature from those early reports was quite accurate. With a varying height of up to 3 metres, 3 metres? That thing was huge! Oh, 3 metres is quite huge, actually. Yeah. The specimen currently referred to as the Faceless has one of the most unusual internal structures I've ever encountered. Where one might expect to find a skeletal foundation, we instead see a series of malleable, chitin-like structures providing various points for the expansion of several equally unusual fluid membranes. The membranes in question are responsible for the Faceless's extraordinary ability to mirror the form of a human in recirculating key cellular combinations via an elaborate internal structure. The Faceless is capable of forming solid shapes while also mirroring colours and textures without physical sampling. What the hell? As of yet, we've only seen evidence of the Faceless attempting to imitate humans, but not other species or inanimate objects. Whether or not this is a limitation of their genetic makeup, or an intentional manipulation of their abilities by the aliens, we cannot say at this time. Ooh, a mimic beacon. The mimic beacon generates a holographic decoy to draw enemy attacks for one turn. It is deployed like a grenade, thrown to the site where the decoy will appear. Handy! Okay, fine.
I'll see that work begins.
Alien encryption,
Commander.
Our actual mission research,
when I have a full report
is the next one to go. So, we're still grabbing some structures for 3 days.
Commander, we just got word that the Resistance hit an advent supply line. We have an opportunity to salvage some high-value materials, assuming we can clear out the alien forces guarding the site first.
It looks like we've got a mission. Commander, the Resistance has relayed information concerning an advent supply line. We should disrupt the transport. You! There! Operation Dawn Shield, ready to troop to move available alien technology. So I can get some really good resources if I go and do that. This one here. But before I go and do that, let me check my troops first. See what we got going on. Soldiers at the ready! Baron's back! Good stuff! Estrella Serrano and Knight, Ming Zhang, Kate Taylor and Kate Taylor. So, Drazek Khan and Athena will not make this mission. Baron can, so Baron shall. However, I guess it's time to introduce UDF 2 member number 5, which is who? Sniper? Right, we're going to make a specialist, and our specialist number 2 shall be Wozza. UDF2 man Wozza. So here we go. Give him my name. Wow, where'd the Q come from? Wow, where'd the X come from? Typing left-handed is not very easy. Last name, I'm not entirely sure. Can we just leave a blank for now? Wozza Knight. Is that your last? Oh, fine. That'll do. Doop. You're also UK. You're not female. You're male. Wow. Well, slap it. Right. So, for Wozza, we are going to give him a helmet of sorts. I don't know. We'll do his hair first. Where do I do face mods? There we go. Let's pick a good face for Wozza. Face A, fine. Let's give him some decent hair. Wozza hair shall be brushed up short. Short. Simple short. Short of some short. I would like some short hair of some short. Wow, pigtails! Spikes. Give him a mohawk, shall we? Right, we'll just go with the shorts. We'll take a brushed up short for Wozza. His hair colour can stay whatever it was. It's black. He has no facial hair. We're going with standard eye colour, which looks red but somehow is brown. Oh, you know, we'll go with that one. We'll go with that one. Skin colour's fine. No, we'll go number 2. And armor, Wozza armor. That would be red slash black, black slash red. Now Drazek's already red, so if I make Wozza black with red accents, that might look cooler as an alternative to just making him red, just like Draz. 79 for that red. That's cool, but we'll have to prop him up a bit. Start with the arms. Now, Wozza's going to be a hacker, because Athena is the med, or medic. So Wozza's going to be mostly Hackman. Mostly Pac-Man. What about his special? Can I not use in combat with other part selection? Oh, Deco. Oh, okay. So I can give him some fancy arms with the new steampunky style DLC. But I don't think I will, because it doesn't suit Wozza. Well, that looks really cool though. It does look cool, but it doesn't suit him. So why has he got a leather strap? I don't want leather straps! Oh, it's something with good accents as well, so... Well, the five is good. Let's give him some legs. Shorts. Oh, come on. Give him some decent legs. Yeah, legs five. Legs five is good. Legs six. Three. Two. One. No. Four. Five. Six. We'll go legs five. And Mr. Torso, we are going to go something have some nice red accents on it, which I think, where's his arms gone? Just notice his arms have disappeared. Well, that's kind of weird. Torso 5, you know what, Torso 5, no, come on, you're breaking the mold. Doesn't fit, does it? Right, well, Mr. Hacker Torso, you're going with number 3. I think number 3 looks cool. Your arms, come back. Give me that arms back. Arms 5. Well, there we go. That looks good. We're looking good here. Any upper face props? Give us some aviators. I'm going to give us some aviators. Some lower face props? Nope, none. Oh, the samurai mask looks really cool, though. Especially in black, that looks really good. Patterns, right, hacker. Hacker pattern, who has hacker pattern? Digital is Athena. Classic, I'm sure someone else has got alien. Someone's got ton, oh, hex. I like hex, but who's got hex? Is Drazek using hex? Happy faces. We'll give him happy faces. Hearts, dots. Dots looks cool. Stripes is cool. Shimmer. I'm thinking stripes, because I'm also trying to keep an eye out for what I'm going to use for the last character. So I'm going to give Wozza stripe, and no face paints. Though, just have a quick peek on these again. Yeah, no face paint. His weapon color is going to be red. Or is it going to be black? No, it's going to be red, because that sets against his armor quite well. And I think there we go. We now have UDF2 Wozza. Join the crew. He is a... He's a what? A specialist. And he's going to be my hacker style specialist. As opposed to Athena being the healer style. Just have a quick look at weapon upgrades. Apparently, of course, I can upgrade my weapons, can't I? The first rate of the mission does not cost an action. Increase aim. What is Baron using? Nothing. Really? Alright, Baron's going to go with the free reload. And Wozza might just have to go with the aim, because why not? Yes. Alright. Wozza's joined the crew. We have a mission. We have a mission.
Setting course
launch
for the
mission.
Arctic.
Wozza, you must save the day. You need to infiltrate these aliens and smash their run. Aiding Baron. Destroy them aliens and get those stuffs. Hold on, who am I taking? Right, I'm taking Baron, I got a grenade out. I'm taking Wozza, I got a specialist. I should take a sharpshooter to back me up, and I should take a range. And just in case, a Skulljack. Do I have a new sword he can use? Oh, I unlocked the new sword, but I guess I haven't built it. I'm using a shock. How do I build the new sword? I wonder if I can go back and quickly make the new sword. Baron, an acid grenade. That would be kind of cool. Let's give him an acid grenade. But then should I give the acid grenade to what? No, I should give it to Baron. Baron, you're running an acid grenade. Wozza, you're going to take a heal pack. But I don't have a heal pack! Oh, boy! Let's just make sure. Yes, there we go. There we go! And Mr. Sniper, you're just standard grenade. Miss Sniper. Done! Launch mission! Apologies, guys. This is going to be a long episode because I spent a lot of time researching. But no worries. We'll get there.
Sky Ranger deployed.
In position for deployment.
One of our resistance contacts sent word of an Advent troop transport they managed to disable in this area, and the aliens have apparently struggled to get it moving again. This is our chance to strike. Anything we can recover from that transport will be a boost to our efforts. Move in and secure the surrounding area. Eliminate all hostile contacts with extreme prejudice.
Extreme prejudice!
Menace 1-5, the Advent troop transport is nearby. Engage Concealed. And eliminate Good. All hostile forces.
Okay, so my objective is avoid destroying critical supplies and neutralize all enemy targets. So it's just an assassinate mission, really. Get in, kill everyone. No timer, take your time, set up a good ambush, and this map is huge. Zoom out a bit. Which way am I supposed to go? That's the corner, so I'm guessing going kind of left. Well, there's a building here. So yeah, we'll go left. But who's first? I should be using the SMGs really instead of the shotguns because it gives you more move. Alternatively, maybe Wozza should be using the SMG. We'll see.
Moving to position.
Oh, in you go. Miss Estella Serrano. You're gonna head up quite high because I need to get you on the roof so you can snipe some people's. Ming Zhang, you are here.
Solid copy.
And Baron, you're going to back up everybody. You're going to back up everybody how? We're still in sneaky mode. So what we need to do is identify the targets, set up a nice ambush for them, and then kill them all.
Moving to designated coordinates.
Right, where could they be? Right, first things first, Estrella, you need to get up on high, and
Let's
probably there is a good spot, assuming you don't get caught. I'm always wary of running too far forward in case I accidentally run into someone's line of sight. I don't see anyone though. Where are they? Are they inside? Are they outside? Where's the enemy and where's the cargo? Who we got? Ming Zhang. Shall I send you up? You can sort of sit lookout as well. Still nobody.
Order's confirmed. On the move.
Wozza. open the door. Yay. Again, still nobody.
On the move.
Baron. No, don't go jumping through windows now, you'll alert everyone.
That's affirmative.
Are you really going to go up and then jump down when you could have quite easily just ran around the corner? So weird. Oh, we'll see you.
Moving on target.
Come on, there's got to be some aliens somewhere. Alien activity. Where from? Where are you? Where are you? Okay, Mr. Ming. Oh, it looks like there's something here. But no, that's the end of the map. That's the edge of the map. So they've got to be in that direction.
Orders confirmed. On a move.
Got to be up here somewhere.
Without
there we
go. Introduction of human DNA. These Wait. Creatures once operating under the guise of thin men, now show their true form. A purely reptilian species.
No reason for them to
What
hide.
The hell?
The aliens don't need an infiltration unit anymore.
Those are the thin men? What, the gangly little humanoid-looking aliens from XCOM 1 are actually snakes? Well, that's crazy. That's definitely crazy. Okay, well, we've seen them now, so... So, where's Athena? No, Estrella, sorry. Estrella, you... We know the enemy's in that direction. There's got to be more beyond. But I definitely want to be looking in that direction. So, if you run up and plonk yourself
Location
sort of around
confirmed.
Here... Get you ready for the ambush next turn. All I need to do is not get seen. Right, Ming Zhang, you can stay there and we'll stick you on Overwatch just in case. Wozza, you should probably make your way around because we're going to need you on this side of the map. No, you just ran through the glass, you fool! Oh man, that's alerted them. Or not. Or not. Okay, fine. You're not such a fool. Baron.
Overwatch.
Oh, there. They're coming from that side as well. I prefer to fight one group at a time. But at least they haven't seen. Let's go. What's going on? What's with the weight? Okay. Did they move? Oh, they did. They moved over the... Well then... Since we got no time and we just have to kill all the enemies, I'm just going to hunker down at this base and just start smashing some skulls, I think. So, Baron, you really need to come back because we need you to defend. And we need a good spot for you, a spot with some good armor. Or you're going to have to sit there, you haven't got a choice. But we will put you on Overwatch.
Scanning.
Wozza, you're going to also sit on Overwatch there, because you've got some good cover there.
Overwatch.
Ming, you're going to... You're going to wait, because I might... want to go up and skulljack one of them. But Estrella, you're going to snipe that alien snake in the face! Oh wow, that was a good shot! Critical
hit! Destroyed.
Right in your alien face! Oh, you know I'm here now. But I'm ambushing you! Oh, you missed. Baron, come on, take him out.
Come on!
Yes!
That's the way to do it! Confirmed. Now, I'm no longer hidden, but those guys must definitely know I'm here by now. I'm just going to sit Ming on Overwatch and just wait for them to come for me. I think that's the best way to push. There we go. Oh, a shotgun Overwatch. I forgot you had a shotgun.
I'll get him next.
Should have given a right. Alright, my turn again. That means. Right, Ming is going to stab some guy in the doozy. Oh, but I want him to Skulljack, really. But I can't get close enough to Skulljack. But it doesn't really want me to Skulljack. I don't know. Oh, I can only use it on commanders and stuff, can't I? Okay, fine. Right, so, Wozza. Wozza, you need to move up. But also stay in cover. So you're going to go... Estella's going straight for a snipe in the face, of which 67% is not the best. Baron. I could launch an acid grenade, or it's just straight up frag grenade. Can I hit two people? I think I can. It looks like a shot to me. That's definitely a shot
here,
to
catch.
Smash him, Baron. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay, so, Ming, do you reckon you can get behind? No, you can't. You can't run that far. Can't run that far. You're in full cover where you are, though, so you should, probably should stay there. Do I go crazy and make him run up and stab the guy in the face? If I did that, would Estella have a better chance? Risk it for a biscuit. Go on, we'll do it. No, I don't want a fire weapon, I want to chop him. I'm going for the slash attack. Slash attack, come on. There we go. Slash attack. Holy- oh, good, I flanked them. So I'm flanked, but they're also flanked, target which means eliminate. I get... better chance to hit. Estella should be able to. Yes, 87%. Go for it. Only two damage.
Right on the margins.
God. Well, that's not good, but that's very nice. Hold on, we've got aid protocol. So if we put it on, hopefully he won't completely die. Plus 20 defense should keep him up. They're flanked, so are they... Whoa, what's going on there? What was that?
Taking fire!
You think there's some kind of liquor from...
What was
from... that,
that
game?
What's oh that? Oh. I'm okay.
Wait! Baron! Baron, get off the floor!
Took some damage here!
Why did you just flop onto the floor like a... floppy. Is he stunned? Is he gonna get... Or have I just lost Baron for the whole match? Well, that's not good. That's really not... Oh, Ming finished the job. Ming looks pretty cool, eh?
Hostiles pacified.
Yes, pacified. You're freaking dead. That's what. Fire a sniper rifle in your face. Kill him. You didn't kill him, did you? No, you. That's rubbish.
Okay.
But Wozza will finish the job. Do you reckon Wozza can pick up Baron? I've got stabilize. I don't know. I'll find out. Let's just take this guy out.
Eliminated.
So that's two groups done.
That didn't feel good.
Unfortunately, Ming's poisoned. He's still poisoned. Which could be quite bad. He might end up dying if I'm not careful. Let's bring him. Bring Ming. Ming needs a hit. Baron needs some kind of pickup.
Move out, target we'll get Wozza in.
No, I can carry him. I can heal. No, this is useless. How do I pick up Baron? Fine.
Come on, get back in the fight.
We'll give Ming a. Baron's just gonna have to lay on the floor for the whole rest of the fight. And Estella needs a reload.
Oh yeah.
And overwatch. Now where's the enemy? I'm just gonna carry Baron around. Okay, so Ming is no longer poisoned. Right, Ming, you're gonna run forward because we need to find the rest of the enemies. We've got to finish this round before Baron just, I don't know, he's not gonna do anything. He's on the floor, unconscious. Oh, hold on, what have we got? So is this a little base? Avoid destroying any supplies, but get rid of the rest of the targets. Where are the rest of the targets? That's the question.
Will do.
Overwatch.
I've got movement here.
Are they? Oh, there you are. Well, I found you. Do I risk running straight in like a nutter? I think I do.
Moving out.
They already know we're.
I've got eyes on advent troops.
Ah, come on! Now you're gonna get punched in the face, Mr. Command. Okay, Estella cannot shoot from where you are, Estella. Tell you what, they know we're here, so I'm actually gonna pull back. I think.
Affirmative.
If I pull back, make them come for me. And just overwatch it up. Oh, but Wozza needs cover because they're coming from that direction. So just pop
understood.
Over.
Moving out. On overwatch.
So you're not. And then I. And you're. Okay, they can see me from that far away. Great. You're not. You're really going to shoot me from that far away? What the heck? Yes. Come on, take him out. Take him. Oh, you missed.
Enemy
you suck.
Still up.
Well, that's a long run. What? Unconscious, but damaged. Oh, man. That's two down for the cat. I've only got two more. Estella and Wozza. Oh, and Wozza got sh. What? The- Estella, what you do? You want Overwatch? You should be shooting the crap out. That's the way to do it. Baron's down, and Ming's down. And Wozza's damaged. Alright, let's get you in.
Moving on target.
Wozza, you just need to keep running and overwatching.
I'm on it.
What was that? I hope that's not another group. I really hope that's not another group. Right, I've got a trooper that I can kill or an officer at 75% chance. 75% chance to kill. Oh, Wozza's not going to be able to smash them. Right, let's take the guaranteed shot. Yes. We need to ensure Wozza's survival. Oh, Ming's got one health left. What's wrong with Ming? He didn't take damage in the last match, did he? The last rap. Oh, and I can't even say. What about aid protocol? Alright, well, I just hope to God that they don't execute Ming whilst I'm sitting here cowering behind a tree.
Move into designated position.
Back up what? And over.
Affirmative, covering now.
Okay, leave Ming. There we go. Shoot him down. Alright, we've got a good shot. Don't. Oh, Jesus.
Incoming fire.
Jesus. Oh, I need to reload. Oh, this is not good. 34% chance to... Alternatively, I have a 47% chance. Oh. Alright, well, if I run back, will he run forward to try and get me? And will Estella shoot him in the head? That is the question. That is the question. Can I actually run back enough to find a decent spot to hide them?
Closing yeah. On target position now.
Alright, you stay. This is called run the hell away tactic. Overwatch. Now you run in and you get shot in the face. Alternatively, you can shoot me from that far away and kill Wozza.
Like
that's not good. Wozza, no! Wozza's dead on his first mission! Why? Why did you kill Wozza? Why? Why do this? Ming's still alive. Baron's still alive. Wozza! Wozza, you're dead! You're a pool of blood on the floor! No! We will avenge you! We will avenge you! Stupid end. Die! This is for what? Revenge! Revenge shot in the face!
Nailed him! Need to get oh. Him confirmed.
All hostiles are down. Man, that was the last trip!
Status accomplished.
Ah. Well, I'm afraid Wozza didn't make it, guys. Wozza was with us for the briefest of moments. We're gonna have to take a sample of his DNA and clone him, I think. Clone Wozza, and he can join us again at another day. Damn it! Can't believe I lost Baron. Well, I didn't lose him, but he got smashed in the face quite early on. And Ming also got smashed in the face. Those damn shock troopers, they're nasty! Definitely man of the hour, or woman of the hour, is Serrano here. Just sniped everyone in the face. 6 kills, awesome. Maybe I should have more than one sniper. Maybe I should have 2 snipers. Instead of 2 gunners or specialists. 2 sharpshooters might be quite good actually. Alright, well, that's enough fun for one day. I'm going to stop here and I'll see you guys in the next episode of XCOM 2. Until then, goodbye.